Hey guys, Brian Hunt here with you again. In this video, it's going to be a little bit different. I'm doing a tutorial on how you can take some of your existing 16 by 9 footage, the kind of footage we all shoot and love to shoot, that landscape style footage, not the vertical, but how you can use that without having to crop into it for some great Instagram posts. And really, it's a cool way to show a bunch of footage stacked on top of each other. I posted this a bunch of times onto Instagram. It works really well. You can use that vertical look. And again, you're using a widescreen image and being able to stack that on top of each other. So what I've done is I've made a template for myself for having four images on the screen or five images. I have that link below in the description. You guys can download that, use that for free. And I'm going to show you guys just how I do that, how I kind of process this stuff and get it working that way. And again, for me, it's a cool way to share a bunch of footage. I have tons and tons of stuff that I've shot over the years, you know, 20 plus years of doing video work. You know, the last 15 of it has been in HD or so, and then more so into the 4K in the last, I guess, almost 10 years. So, but really, we're always capturing stuff in that widescreen. Typically, I've barely ever gone out and just shot vertically on purpose unless a client's asked for it like that. So let's go through here and show you how to do that. So I've made this Insta post. This is a 4-up. I'm going to use a 5-up because the footage I'm using is stuff I shot in South Africa, 2018. This was on a safari, and I actually was able to capture the Big Five. So the Big Five in South Africa is considered the buffalo, the elephant, the rhino, leopard, and the lion. Those are the Big Five. So I have an image. I have a bunch of images of all of them, but I'm going to try to find five great clips of all of them, stack them on top of each other, and show you how we do that. So first off, I'm going to go in here. I'm going to go to a new sequence. This is in Adobe Premiere. You could do this in your other editing software and stuff. So name this Big Five. I have a vertical sequence that I made. It is the opposite of 1080p if you're doing that for Instagram. So instead of 1920 by 1080, it's 1080 by 1920. And I have that set to, I'm actually going to change this to 30 frames per second, or when I export to 30 frames per second, because Instagram prefers 30 frames per second over 24. Okay. Then we're just going to grab my template here. We're going to drop this down here into the bottom layer. And then we are going to stretch this out a little bit, you know, say 15 seconds, 20 seconds, doing a pretty short reel here. So our short post, and there you can go. You can see it have those different colors there. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my footage here. I'm maybe just going to start with the buffalo. The buffalo I got was kind of a bit of a haggard buffalo. So this is only a 5-second shot. This is a 12-second shot. This might be a bit better. And you can see it's a widescreen shot here. This was shooting handheld. This was a GH4 or GH5 outside of a very vibrating Jeep. So, or, you know, a Land Rover that was taking us around on the safari. They're hard to kind of work with or to shoot from, especially when they're vibrating. A lot of the newer safaris actually have electric vehicles that are their ones that they're using. So this is a better shot here. This is a bit more stable. Got some slow-mo here. He's moving his head around a bit. This was actually the only water buffalo or buffalo we saw, African buffalo. And he was a bit rough looking. So I'm take this. That's 12 seconds. Let's bring this over a little bit longer. I'll bring that down. I'm going to put that onto the first layer. This is going to be my bottom image. I can play around with stuff after I get stuff sorted here, but I want to, you know, kind of have this on each layer where they are to make that easy for me to figure stuff out. So I'm going to take this. I am going to go over to my controls, effects controls. I'm going to make this 30%. I think it's actually a little bit, you can go a little bit smaller than that if you want. That's 30%. Then I'm going to bring the position down on this. And let's see here. I'm going to play around with the spacing here a bit. And then I'm going to go into the effects controls, or the effects, sorry. I'm going to go for crop. bring the crop tool down onto this, and then I'm just going to use the crop tool to kind of help fit it exactly in there. And again, I can play with this a bit, you know, bringing this down a bit till I get somewhere where I kind of like it. You can scale as well, because there is lots of room to play with this image, especially when you have a 4K image that you're using this way, bringing it into a vertical 1080p or 1920, I guess, timeline. So that was the first one. I'm going to go in and get the next clip here. So what do I want to use next? Do I want to use a shot of an elephant? This one's an elephant kind of on a river here that's kind of drinking some water. It's a dried up riverbed. This is some more with a group of elephants in the water riverbed. This is on a really long lens. I think this is on a 400 mil, so it's a little bit hard to keep stable. These were some elephants at sunset, and it's a bunch of them walking. Kind of a beautiful shot that we got there. Yeah, this might be the shot. I don't know. It's just kind of a butt shot. Yeah, I'm not sure. Maybe this shot is a better one, the sunset one here. So let me see here. I do like this kind of straight on one too. This one's quite a bit closer. This is a moving shot here. This is kind of an interesting shot here. This is 10 seconds. Let's see how long this will play out for and how well this works, but it's moving its ears around. But, you know, the thing to think about is how you're going to be framing and cropping the top and bottom. You're not going to see the full elephant there. I would see more of the full elephant on this shot here. So let's take this. I think I know this shot here. They think it throws some water up on its face. Maybe not. Okay, so we're going to get here. It's just kind of the elephant there in the grass. 15 seconds or so. We're going to bring that deck down on top of two here. And again, the same thing. I'm going to go to effects controls. I'm going to bring this down to 30%. I am then going to bring this down to the next layer here. And it's going to be covering up this other one, but I'm going to play with this. I'm going to go to my crop tool. Bring my crop tool in. I'm going to bring down the bottom, the top. That's the top there. So I want to bring this actual whole thing down a little bit more. Maybe I can go a bit smaller with this as well. Well, 27. Let's go here. 29. It's probably the max. I'm going to bring this down, the top down a bit there. And then the bottom. And I don't want to cut off its leg there a bit, so I'm going to bring this up a bit more, just a tiny bit more. And I have to crop the bottom a bit. And then crop the top again. And as you can see here, it's pretty an easy process of just going through, putting each one down. Then I'm going to bring in another shot here. Lion. There's a nice shot of the lion on the side here. He was just chilling in the heat. Again, this was shot on a GH5 handheld. I forget what lens I had on here, but you know, it's a bit tricky sometimes to shoot this stuff, I'll tell you that. Again, maybe whatever your shortest clip is, you can make it that. there's a lot of talk about, you know, 7 second, 10 second Instagram reels or Instagram. Yeah. Instagram reels, that being kind of an optimum, kind of ultimate. I can't speak. That being one of the best ways to post onto Instagram because it is nice and short and sweet and gets people's interest and apparently it gets a lot of engagement that way. So let's throw this clip down here. This one is going to crop in quite a bit on the lion. So I'm going to bring this down. Scale to 29%. I am then going to probably need to see how I crop this. Go crop, effects, crop, and I'm going to do the top. And the bottom. There we go. We have a lion, an elephant, and a, you know, and maybe there would be a better shot to use of the lion that's a bit farther back. To see a bit more of the lion. Is this shot, but I think there's some problems with me holding it. This might be a better shot to use. It just might fit in there a bit better. Crop wise and seeing a bit more of the line. Although I do like the eyes here a lot with his eyes being open. But what we're going to do here is we're going to try. I'm going to put this on top. Stack that on top of the other one. And I'm going to bring down this audio here. I don't need that there. Effects again. I think you guys are kind of getting an understanding of what we're doing here. It's pretty straightforward. Really, the guide has helped me a lot to do this stuff. And it's a fun way to show off your footage that you have. So, grab the bottom a bit here. I'm going to move this whole thing up. So that's basically it. It's very simple. I've kind of go through a lot of the stuff. I've stacked up all 5 images now. What I would do next would be just to kind of match all the color on these, getting them as close as I can. I might put a LUT on top of it as an adjustment layer as being the whole thing, just to kind of affect all that stuff, give it a little bit of a look. And then I'm going to export it as the same resolution, 30 frames per second as the sequence. Send it to my phone and upload to Instagram. That's really it. Pretty simple. Hope you guys like this one. Let me know if you want to see more videos like this. And if you like the video, give me a thumbs up and think of subscribing to the channel. See you guys in the next one.